Hello, community. After fine-tuning our T5 and Flying T5, just this short interrupt, I want to show you something really cute, and this is about LLM and Stanford ALPACA, the new Stanford ALPACA large language model, how they fine-tuned it. It is really cute. Have a look. Now, in theory, you know, we have our pre-trained large language model, pre-trained on a billion sentences. And then we have a huge training data set, tens of thousands of sentences, where we have the data set for fine-tuning then a pre-trained LLM on a very specific task. Task can be summarization, translation in another language, whatever. And then we go here to a cloud data center. We take 8A100 or Hopper 100 data center tensor core GPUs from NVIDIA, and we let it run for some hours. And we do the fine-tuning, where all the weights of the model are modified. What did Stanford do? Stanford, as here, according to our theory, took Meta's LLaMA 7 billion large language model, which was pre-trained, according to Meta, on a trillion tokens. And then it was interesting. Stanford said, okay, now we scientists, we write some examples. And they wrote 175 human-written examples, English text examples of tasks, input-output. And they say, this 175, take it as a blueprint. And they went to OpenAI's API, choose the text DaVinci OS3 model, the GPT 3.5 model. And based on the 175, OpenAI generated 52,000 examples where they use this then as a training data set. You have four specific tasks, and the task was more or less to chat. So you see, they used an AI to generate from a very small amount of human-written examples, some synthetic examples, 52,000. And this is exactly what we need. We need a huge training data set for fine-tuning here in a classical way. And then, of course, they said, beautiful, yeah, supervised fine-tuning, of course. And then they took here this LLaMA 7 billion model with the 52K training data set, and they put it here on a 640 gigabyte GPU cluster, 8x an 80 gigabyte A100 from NVIDIA. And they called then the resulting fine-tuned model ALPACA, ALPACA 7B, since the base model was Meta's LLaMA 7B. So you see, this is beautiful because they create here what they need for their supervised fine tuning. They need a huge training data set. And they use here OpenAI's API to do exactly this based on 175 single human written examples. An example can be sentence 1, 2, 3. This is it. So because OpenAI invested so much here, they can use now the quotation mark, intelligence of OpenAI GPT 3.5 to generate here this synthetic data set. And then they just go and classical fine tune it. This is what is Stanford ALPACA all about. But the nice thing is the cost structure behind this. Now, Stanford asked Meta for some researcher access, so I don't know what they paid and whatever, but let's say nothing. Okay, now, OpenAI's API, you know, you have to pay for the token and you have to pay for some other things. Now, Stanford University tells us they paid $500. For all of this 52K training data set, they paid $500. It's a university rate. And of course, they did some clever algorithm. But for $500, unbelievable to generate a data set, a task-specific data set. And then they have also a university rate, of course. They took, I think, some hours, only three epochs on the 640 gigabyte GPU cluster. And they just spent $100 as a university. So for $600, they get a relatively medium performing LLaMA 7B, and they get an excellent performing LLM, ALPACA 7B, fine-tuned on a specific task. Now, let's say this task is to chat or to translate or whatever you have. So this is amazing. You use an API from an AI to generate your data set and you can have supervised fine-tuning. Now, just to be absolutely clear, the middle part here, where we generate our training data set, this is not a fine-tuning approach. This is ICL. This is in-context learning. Here we do not change anything at all in the weights of the GPT 3.5 model. We are operating here in inference mode. We have here GPT 3.5 prompt. When I input here in the prompt, example A, sentence 1, 2, 3, example B, sentence 1, 2, 3, I'll show you an example in a second. And then I ask the machine, hey, can you generate for me similar examples on similar topics, with similar verbs, with similar action, with similar whatever? And then you get 52K data set. The last step, of course, is the classical fine-tune step. You go, I don't know, AWS, Google Cloud, whatever you go, you have 640 gigabyte GPU, and you do the fine-tuning. Beautiful. Now, to generate this data set from December 2022, from University of Washington, Tehran Polytech, Arizona State University, Johns Hopkins, and Allen Institute for AI, you see here the authors, they have this new method called self-instruct, aligning language model, large language model, with self-generated instruction, so that the humans do not have to come up with some intelligent prompt design. The machine now self-generates instruction. An AI generates now similar instruction based on a human data set. So we have here an instruction-tuned language model. And they say, based on the finding that LLMs pre-trained can be prompted in inference to generate new and novel instruction when presented with some existing examples. So for every step, they took 8 task instructions from the pool of the 175. And of 8 instructions, 6 were the human-written ones, and 2 were the synthetic ones from the last run, which the model generated. And then they let it run and generated 52Ks. Beautiful. Yes, they have a set of instruction input-output instances. If you want to have a look here, this is like the prompt they used for input-first approach for the instance generation. Or if you look for the output-first approach, read the paper. It is rather simple. And you see now what the GPT 3.5 came up with. You have here the instruction. Instruction is, for example, write a letter from the perspective of a cat. And the output is then the owner, I'm writing, yes, yes, yes. So you have instruction, input, output, great. Or you say instruction, give a word, find out its length and the number of vowels. Input, the word is hello, and you get the answer. So beautiful. Now, if you want to have a closer look, there's a beautiful GitHub repo for you, Stanford ALPACA, an instruction following LLaMA model. They show you the 52,000 data they used for fine-tuning the model, which they generated with the GPT 3.5. And then they show you the code for fine-tuning the model, but I would say this is rather experimental because Hugging Face has not officially supported the LLaMA models at the time. So we, Stanford, fine-tuned the LLaMA with Hugging Face Transformer Library by installing it from a particular fork with a little bit of help from the people, from the nice people from Hugging Face. So I would say if you come back in 1 or 2 weeks, everything should, I hope Hugging Face will have everything published. You will find Stanford ALPACA on Hugging Face. Maybe if you see this video, it is already uploaded on Hugging Face. Those are the orders, beautiful. And I can say Stanford is really interested to release here the assets in the near future, to release all the model weights for Stanford ALPACA. They have reached out, as they say in their publication, to Meta to obtain guidance, you know, intellectual property rights, to release the ALPACA model weights, since this is based on the LLaMA model weights for the ALPACA 7B and for fine-tuned version of larger LLaMA models. So I think in the future we will get here a lot of new model weights that we can use in our models. But anyway, I think if you want to play around a little bit with this idea, it is so beautiful. You take an AI, you create your data set, you have a huge training data set, you have a supervised fine-tuning now available for you. You take any fitting, suitable, pre-trained LLM, and you have a particular task in your mind or you, for your company, you want to do some summation task for financial data or for, I don't know, insurance task or whatever you have. You have in your company some written examples, I hope 175 examples, then you generate with OpenAI's API, now with the GPT-4 model, some additional synthetic training data, hopefully very similar. Then you have a huge training data set that you can go and fine tune now, let's say FLAN T5, 11 billion parameter with your company specific training data set on here, cloud computer infrastructure. And you have a fine-tuned corporate-specific model that is now on task one specialized. So what you do, if you have two tasks, let's say the second task is, I don't know, you want to translate it somehow, whatever you have, you do the same again. You create now your training data set for the second specific task. You write down, I don't know, 100 human written example in your company, how you would like to have it in your style, with your particular version, with your template, whatever you have, whatever is corporate identity for you, you generate synthetic data sets and you then train it on a second task. You fine tune it now on the second task. So you end up with a fine tuned model with your corporate FLAN T5 model that is fine tuned on two specific tasks, that is really high performance just on these two tasks. So you see, and if this is true, I don't know, for university, maybe you have to pay a little bit more if you are a for-profit enterprise. But you see, compared with tens of thousands of dollars for fine-tuning here, those huge LLMs, this is amazing that you can take a small 7 billion, maybe 11 billion parameter model, and you do not have to go to 500 billion or 1,000 billion parameter models to achieve this accuracy and to achieve the performance you are looking for in your company. So this is the beauty of ALPACA 7B, but you see, even the small models with a highly specific training data set for one specific task, and then you add on more tasks, you can have a fine-tuned task-specific LLM that has some amazing performance, and the costs are minimal if you compare it to the classical way. So if you want to have a look at the data, this is very easy. We just go here, data release. You have here ALPACA data JSON. Maybe I increase it a little bit. And here you have here now your data. As you can see, we have instruction, then we have input and output, instruction, input and output, sometimes with an input, sometimes without an output. But you see, it is a very easy to generate the data set. If you have something in mind that you want to have, you want to imprint a pattern in your language for your specific topic. And then regarding fine tuning, we have here the hyperparameter, classical batch size 128, the learning rate, the epochs, maximum length. Yes, yes, yes. Hugging Face is now officially supporting the LLaMA models. I show you. Yes, I show you right now. So as you can see, we're here in Hugging Face. We have here LLaMA, beautiful. Please note, we are here in the main version, so you have installation from the source. This is the brand new overnight version. So please do not forget, install from source, and then you remember the weights for the LLaMA models can be obtained by filling out this form. First name, family name, location, affiliation, intended use, previous related publication to have anything else. And then you can have fun with the license agreement. Beautiful. And then you convert here with this conversion script. Beautiful. This in a Hugging Face Transformer format. And off you go. This is it. Here we go. From Transformer, import LLaMA for causal language model, LLaMA tokenizer. This is what you do. You have to LLaMA config, causal, here we go. And here you have a very easy example from Transformer, import auto-tokenizer, here we go. You have your prompt. You can have here, return the PyTorch tensor for your tokenizer. You generate here, and then you have a batch decode with the skip, the special token is true, and you got an answer. So here you can see this here is the LLaMA model, the inference run, if you want. So beautiful, where I was. So now that it is officially supported, you have the LLaMA model. You can download the LLaMA model, the pre-trained LLaMA model by Meta, and you're ready for the fine-tuning. And for the fine-tuning, I have to show you that. Here is it. 5 days ago. And here you see. We operate with data classes. If you're not familiar with data classes, please get familiar. We will use it when I explain to you JAX and FLAX. We will use only data classes in JAX. Here we have transformer. Beautiful. You have the prompt, and then you have your model arguments, the data arguments, the training arguments for your model. Save the model, yes. Smart tokenizer, yes, beautiful. Resize tokenizer and embedding. Unoptimal version, yes, beautiful, beautiful. You have your tokenizer, okay. The pre-processing for your data. Then you have your supervised data set, beautiful. You know this, we have it. Then you have your classical data collator for supervised data set. This is everything you need, but it's nice to see ready. You can use it, train it, run. And here we have the final training algorithm here. So what we have our transformer, our argument parser, our auto model for causal language model from pre-trained. Here we have our parse. Then we have our auto tokenizer. If the tokenizer pad token is none, then we have a smart tokenizer, yes. And then we have some special tokens, you know this. And then you say trainer. Trainer, here's your trainer, your model, your tokenizer, and your different training arguments that you have. Then you have the famous trainer.train command. You can save it. You can save it wherever you want. And this is it. This is here the fine-tuning code that you need to execute here for Stanford ALPACA, the 7 billion parameter model. Now, isn't this beautiful? What else we need to know? Requirements, yeah. NumPy, Rouge Score, Fire, OpenAI, Transformer, Torch, Sentence, Beast, Tokenizer, and W and B. Beautiful. Yes, anything else? Datasheet, training, seek, requirements, prompt. Model card, yeah, you can have a look at the model card. This is the data that I showed you, the fine-tuning data set. And this is it, more or less. So you just have here your command. Yes, 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 yes. As you can see, this is here our train.py file. You have your model path. You have here your alpaca data, the JSON file I showed you. We go here with a specific precision, half precision. Output directory, you define it, the number of training epochs is 3, the training batch size is 4, the evaluation batch size is 4, the accumulation step 8, save strategy is by steps, total limit is only 1, the learning rate is defined, weight decay is 0, you have a specific warm-up ratio, learning rate scheduler type here is a cosine, and then you have some special optimization, beautiful. And this is it. So what else? That specific decoder layer is not stable. Yes, I know, now it is. And of course, you can also fine tune the opt 6.7 billion parameter with this. You just have to give here the model name, Facebook opt 6.7 billion. And as you can see, it works like a charm. Beautiful. Anything else you will find here in the documentation. So here you have it, you have the data set, you have here the fine-tuning code that you apply if you have now the LLaMA model from Meta on Hugging Face Transformer in the main version. You download the nightly version, the latest, greatest version. And this is it. You can go, you can run it. You can generate your personal data set for fine-tuning for your specific task. And that's it. This is it for the moment. Have fun with Stanford ALPACA. So, thank you, Stanford. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in my next video.